Lithium batteries have become the preferred source of power for numerous consumer products we use every day. In fact, I'd guess you have one in your pocket right now, and let me just apologize in advance if you're using a Samsung, your cell phone. Yet, these small but powerful batteries have recently garnered significant attention due to events in which batteries have overheated, caught fire, and even exploded. Since these incidences, IATA has put revised regulations in place to avoid risk when shipping packages containing these batteries. To help you stay compliant, Skylink has prepared a video, a step-by-step process in which to help you prepare for your lithium battery hazmat shipment. Let's take a look. Before we start preparing the shipment, we need to locate the required packing instructions under the UN number in the IATA Dangerous Goods Regulations book. These packing instructions are for all dangerous goods acceptable for air transport with a wide range of options for inner, outer, and single packaging. Now stay with me. All packages containing lithium batteries are classified as Class 9, a miscellaneous dangerous good. UN performance tested boxes are normally required by the packing instructions. These boxes are designed, tested, and certified in accordance with the DOT, ICAO, ICO, International Air Transport, and INDG, IMO requirements. Packing instructions within the IATA Dangerous Goods Regulations state that any shipment containing lithium batteries and cells must be individually packaged in full enclosed inner packaging to provide protection for the battery. Now, the inner package containing the battery must be placed in a sturdy outer container with enough protective packaging material to fill the void to prevent movement. Now, we can't underplay packaging when it comes to shipping lithium batteries, so this is important. A best practice for sealing your UN-approved hazmat boxes is to use the H-taping method, applying at least 3 strips of pressure-sensitive plastic tape that is at least 3 inches wide to both the top and bottom of the package. Before applying anything else to your box, ensure the arrows or this end up is properly positioned and nothing is covering the UN markings on your package. The next step is to apply the appropriate dangerous goods label. The symbol should be affixed at an angle of 45 degrees or diamond shape on the side opposite of the UN markings. The last step to completing your dangerous goods shipment for your lithium battery is to add the shipment label, which will include the shipper and their address, the consignee and their address, and UN number with proper shipping name and quantity of the dangerous goods being shipped. A certified shipper must complete the dangerous goods declaration and attach it to the package before it can leave your or any facility. If you like this video, use the link below to check out our hazmat checklist. It's the 6 vital things to look for with every hazmat shipment. And after you've downloaded that, make sure you join us on Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, and join the conversation. We want to hear from you. We'll see you over there.